Ooglies starts Monday at 5:45, the CBBC channel.
We've come to the end of our epic journey to find the world's next great superhero.
It all began with 13 wannabe heroes. They faced a series of superhero-style missions.
I can do it.
Come on, you can do it!
And nail-biting paradowns.
But the superhero that will paradown and return home is...
Just three made the final. But only one superhero was left standing.
H2O Man.
Today, H2O Man joins us in Hollywood. He comes face to face with his superhero godfather, Stan Lee.
I've been expecting you.
And finally claims comic book immortality.
It's been amazing.
This is Who Wants to Be a Superhero? Welcome to Los Angeles.
Our epic journey to find the world's next great superhero has finally come to an end.
And boy, did we find a pretty amazing superhero.
We certainly did, and we've travelled over 5,000 miles to LA so that H2O Man can claim the ultimate superhero reward, comic book immortality.
Superhero Godfather Stan Lee has been busy creating H2O Man's comic book, and although Stan was monitoring his progress, this will be the first time that they've ever come face to face.
Don't know about you, mate, but I'm pretty excited to see what Stan Lee thinks of our ultimate superhero. But before we do that, let's remind ourselves how H2O Man became the last superhero standing.
H2O Man.
Gold Starlet.
An SGW. The world needs a new superhero. And I can now reveal that that hero is... H2O Man.
Congratulations, H2O Man. Would you like to say a few words?
Every time since I've been here, it's just been so fun, and everybody here, even though like you're not up here, you're still like part of everything, so just thank you.
Heartiest congratulations, H2O Man. I look forward to meeting you in Hollywood very soon. One thing I do love is a happy ending. Excelsior!
Start, I wanted to be the company ultimate superhero, obviously, but actually now I'm here, it's just so much better than I expected, and it's just unbelievable, really.
It really has been an incredible journey, but I think we found a truly worthy hero.
Definitely, but we couldn't do it without Stan Lee. I mean, he really did teach us everything we know about superheroes.
I know, I've still got the headache to prove it.
A true superhero must have heart. Compassion, courage, and integrity.
The big question is, have we done Stan Lee proud?
Let's find out. Come on.
To see you again.
Hey, it's great to see you guys. How are you?
Not too bad.
You know, I've got to say, well done. And what a good job you have done. All 13 superheroes, they were very good. And boy, it must have been a tough job picking just one.
It was tough, especially deciding on the final three superheroes. They were all great in their own way, but I think we chose the worthy superhero.
Yeah, but the big question is, what do you think of our next great superhero, H2O Man?
You know, he is a fantastic superhero because he has all the qualities that a superhero should have. I mean, he's kind, he's caring.
Definitely. Well, he definitely proved that in the water mission. When he gave his barrel to Princess Paul, that was really kind and caring.
Yeah, and also in the break-in, his first thought was Danny. I thought that was pretty cool.
So, yeah, if you could help me, that would be
fine. You're okay?
I'm fine. Thank you very much for asking.
Okay, I will inspect.
Okay.
He's brave and faces his fears.
Well, that's true, because he told us that he was afraid of creepy crawlies, and then what did he do?
Oh, yeah, he picked up not one cockroach, but four cockroaches. That's unbelievable.
I picked up these big, fat, ugly ones, which, like, are really wriggly, and their legs felt horrible, and I almost wanted to cry.
And I think, best of all, he's a great role model.
Yeah, he was brilliant with the kids. They did, like, a talk to the children, and he was spreading his H2O message, and I think he went down very well. Yeah. He was very popular.
Very popular.
And, of course, I forgot one very important thing.
What's that?
Well, he's stylish and charming, isn't he?
Definitely. He's definitely a charmer.
He certainly is. Now, one of the main reasons why we liked H2O Man is that he learned from his mistakes.
Definitely. Yeah, there was a few times when me and Mark had to pull him up in the power down of things he'd done wrong, like maybe he was showing off or, you know, not listening to our instructions.
Really, that's what makes superheroes so special. They make mistakes, just like us humans, but it's the way they deal with those mistakes. That's what makes them superhuman.
Now, obviously, we all know a lot about H2O Man, but you actually haven't met him yet, so you don't know anything about Carl, the man behind the costume.
So we thought we'd show you a bit more about his secret identity before you meet him tomorrow. This is the boy behind the cape.
When I'm Carl, I've got loads and loads of hobbies. Every single second of the day, minute of the day, or hour of the day, I'm doing something. I like to go skating with all my friends.
You've really got to be a superhero to try this one.
Also, I like to play guitar in my spare time. We just basically have a jam together.
Hi, Carl.
I play football, I play it every day. Me and H2O Man, we're equally as charming. Yay! Yeah, my life is really, really busy.
Boy, he looks great and so talented.
He is, and you'll be meeting Carl, I mean H2O Man, tomorrow. But let's not forget what this is all about, comic book immortality.
Stan, we are dying to see the comic book.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, it's coming along great, so here. Let me give you a sneak peek.
Oh, yes!
We gave it! Oh.
Okay, that's enough.
What?
Can't see too much.
That's fair enough, Stan. Well, once again, thank you very much for talking to us. It's been a privilege, and thank you for, you know, giving us all your superhero knowledge.
Absolutely, and H2O Man's going to be here soon, so we better get off. Yep. But thank you, always a pleasure, Stan.
Cheers, Stan.
Don't be strangers.
Exactly. Actually, there isn't one more favour you could do for us, is there?
One more favour? Oh, I know.
Go! Happy weddings.
I wish we had the power of teleportation. That Stan Lee is one powerful man.
He is.
Hey!
And I'm so happy that he's happy that we made the right choice about H2O Man. Who knows where he would have teleported us if he didn't like him?
Exactly. Hey, I reckon we've done a good job all in all, and I reckon we should have a chill out on this beach. Come on.
Well, wait a minute. Aren't you forgetting something?
What? My factor 30? No, I got it right here.
No, not that. H2O Man. We're meant to be meeting him on this beach. Oh. He should be here by now.
Well, maybe we've got to pick him up from the airport, or, you know, it's been delayed or something. Give him a ring.
Okay. H?
Yeah.
Call.
Hello?
H2O Man, it's Sam. Where are you? Has your plane landed?
My plane? I don't need a plane. I'm H2O Man. I'll be there in a sec.
Hello?
What?
Oh, I've lost him.
Oh.
Whoa! That was quick. H2O Man, welcome to Los Angeles. Did you enjoy your flight?
Yeah, but I'll tell you something, there wasn't any in-flight movie, but it was a good scenery.
Excellent banter.
Good banter.
Good.
Good. Have you been since becoming the world's next great superhero?
Well, you know, doing my superhero-like duties.
Nice, nice. You're looking forward to meeting Stan?
Yeah, I can't wait to meet the legend himself, Stanley.
Well, we can tell you that your comic book is looking absolutely awesome.
Yeah, you're going to be meeting Stan tomorrow, but as you know, a superhero is never off duty, so we thought that you'd like to spread your H2O message, USA style.
Yeah, okay then, let's go.
Wow! Where's he gone?
Wow! Oh, there he is. I wish he'd stop doing that.
Yeah, or teleport us with him.
Come on, hop on. I'm as strong as H2O.
Okay. Oh!
There you go, guys.
Thank you.
Have a good day. Don't forget to drink it. There you go. Have a nice day.
Have you been spreading the message?
Yep, I've been handing out water to make sure everybody knows how important water actually is to their bodies.
Yeah, especially if you're out in this sun.
Yeah, and don't forget, if you do a lot of sport and exercise, you're going to need a lot of water too. Speaking of which, you two guys know you could do with the workout.
What?
Come on, follow me.
Coming up, we get personal with H2O Man.
This is it. You've beaten off 12 others to become the world's next great superhero.
He faces one last mission.
H2O Man! Help!
And he finally gains comic book immortality.
Oh my word.
So, after an exhausting workout on the beach, it was time to sit down and have a bit of a catch-up with H2O Man.
So, today's the big day.
Yep.
H2O Man's going to meet Stan Lee and become a comic book legend.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, where is he?
I don't know. We need to prepare him. I don't know where he is.
Could you stop doing that, please? Scared the living daylights out of me.
Well, yeah, I am a superhero.
That's true.
That's true.
Now, what's it like as a superhero to be meeting such a comic book legend like Stan Lee?
I think it will, like, complete me and put me up there to be, like, with all the greats like Spider-Man and Iron Man and all of them, really.
Now, before we go off and meet Stan, we want to have a quick chat with you, if that's all right?
Yeah, we do.
Okay, let's just take you back in time, back to the lair. Now, there wasn't just you, there was also 12 other superheroes. You're all living together, so you got to know each other pretty well. What was it like living together?
As I was living with 12 other people, it was noisy some days and quiet some days.
Who were the noisiest? The girls or the boys?
Most of the girls are the noisiest.
Yeah, they're
pretty loud.
So have you stayed in touch with anyone?
Yeah, I stayed in touch with SGW.
Yep.
We were going to go to a Newcastle game a couple of weeks after I come back from here.
Oh, right,
so
wicked.
I can't wait for that.
Oh, that'll be brilliant. Good. Nice one. Anybody else?
Gold Starlet, I've been talking to her quite a lot. She rings me and I ring her and we just have a chat about it.
So all the finalists then?
Now, speaking of the final three, what did you think of your fellow finalists, SGW and Gold Starlet?
I think they were really nice people. They were really nice superheroes as well. I didn't think Gold Starlet was going to be crowned the next great superhero. I thought it was going to be SGW's.
Who did you think in the beginning then?
At the beginning, I thought it was going to be Princess Poor.
Really?
And then halfway through, I thought it was going to be Steel Soldier.
Right.
And then after he went, I thought it was going to be SGW all to the end then.
So you never ever thought at any stage that you were going to be crowned the next great superhero?
Never.
Really? So tell me this, why do you think you were the last superhero left standing?
Obviously, I had something that all the other superheroes didn't, and I think not all the way through it I did like amazing, but I think that I did better than the others, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Which this shows, obviously. So I think that, like I said, I had something that they didn't really.
And what do you think that was?
Can
you put your finger on it?
I had charisma.
Nice.
And oomph about me. I didn't hold back. I just, if I said I was going to do something, I'd do it. I didn't hold back on anything I did.
Well, we found out what your fellow superheroes thought about you becoming the world's next great superhero. Have a look at this.
What I really like about H2O Man is that he's really funny and kind and caring, and he's a really good friend.
Nice.
How good's that? Pink Puffle Girl. Digging your action, mate.
He's a good friend to me, and he, like, help sharing challenges and you get on well with him. And if it wasn't for him, I don't think I would have passed some of the two of the challenges.
What do you think of that? That's nice, isn't it?
Very nice. I didn't really know I did that much.
So you gave him like so much confidence, you're saying there.
Nice. Never realised I did that.
Really?
Yeah.
I think H2O Man is going to be the world's next great superhero because he's confident, he likes to like be the leader, which is good, he's determined, he's like he has all the qualities that a superhero have, and saves everybody who even entered the lair, so he did really well.
He's really good. I think he's going to be a great superhero when he's meeting Stan and everyone. So, yeah, I think he deserved it.
Get lost!
No!
Oh, well, what do you think of that then?
I didn't really think I was that popular.
So out of all the missions, which ones did you find the hardest?
I think mentally it was the one where we had to in the cafe and retrieve a fire's back.
Right, yeah.
Because it was really awkward because one of us was trying to distract him, was trying so hard, but he was so stubborn. It just wouldn't move.
Yeah.
So I think that was the hardest mentally. And the most frustrating one was the toxic skip.
Oh, yeah.
Nightlife took ages. I think everyone's getting really frustrated about that, not just me. Everyone's calling him Nightlife, but more like 9 hours.
Yeah. He was.
Which one did you enjoy the most, though?
I think I enjoyed the swimming one when we had to do the toxic skip because, obviously, like, that's natural swimming, so yeah. I enjoyed that quite a lot.
You were great at that.
You were brilliant in that.
Yeah, really good. Like, do you reckon this opportunity has changed your life at all?
I think it has changed my life in loads of ways, especially like my friendship group, like all the other people that I met in the lair and at the auditions. That I've stayed in touch with a couple of them, so yeah. That's changed that as well.
Okay, so this is it. You've beaten off 12 others to become the world's next great superhero. So we thought it was about time that you were rewarded and that your secret identity, Carl, had a bit of fun.
I'm ready.
Okay, let's do it.
No, Sam and Mark, sit right down. Leave this to me.
During his time in the lair, H2O Man was a charming and charismatic superhero. But of course, he wasn't the only one. There were 12 other wannabe heroes all battling it out to become the next great superhero. Each with their own unique powers and personality.
My sonic scream.
I can freeze things, just use my hands, and it'll be something like this.
Chat-bomb, no bigger than this.
I got the Wonder Woman's hair right, which is ginger.
It's black in it.
She has black and then she has the American thing.
I swear it's ginger.
I don't know.
Now I'm going to ask you to be quiet! Right. My powers are very simple. The power of the force field in a bubble in your hand, but they can use for many different things!
Yeah, you're trying to listen. My best power is, as you all know, bam!
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 Bam! Bam!
Bam!
Doctor Da! Doctor Da! The evilest person in our little town. Meow!
The six girls and seven boys quickly formed separate groups.
Who thinks girls are better than boys?
Me. Totally.
Who thinks boys are better than girls?
They're dolls.
We must have a plan to beat the girls. It's destiny that boys will win.
Yeah, but without girls, where would we be?
Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's right. No one could cook, no one could wash, no one could clean.
They're farting in their beds to make them stinky and smelly, and it will take. Might smell very nice.
And it wasn't long before the pressure of life in the lair caused friction between the superheroes.
So I'm just going to get angry at you lot, right?
Because I seriously, I'm not going to go.
It's Supergirls only over here.
Oh, really? What are they?
I was annoyed. I was really ticked off. I was like, what? That is so unfair.
I feel so good doesn't get on with me. Now I've got to team up with him.
But it never lasted for long.
All right, hugs.
Aww.
I hate hugs. Hugs are disgusting. I think I made a big step towards being friends with everybody because a true superhero would have to be friends with everybody.
Let's start!
Be fun.
Handshake. Oh, we do like a happy ending.
Yeah. Oh. I'm okay.
And although only one person could claim ultimate victory, everyone left the lair a hero.
I feel like a superhero.
It's been really fun being a superhero because you get to help people and for lots of different reasons.
From being here, I've learned about respect and responsibility and bravery.
Hello, Thunder.
Hello, Storm.
I've had an amazing time.
I will continue with my superhero ways, and I think it'll be great to show everybody what it's like to be a superhero.
I especially enjoy being a superhero because I got to make new friends and build up my confidence and just have the whole experience of helping people.
I mean, just being a superhero, just wearing the outfit was a dream come true for me.
Steel soldiers got a girlfriend, steel soldiers got a girlfriend, steel soldiers got a girlfriend.
And her name is Daddy.
I really do now feel like a superhero now that I've done all this.
And who we want to be, superheroes.
Yes.
Welcome to the world-famous Universal Studios. Some of the biggest movies of all time have been made here, including The Mummy, Jurassic Park, and Back to the Future.
Oh, and it's also full of brilliant rides. So, I think it's safe to say we're going to have a pretty good time. You up for it?
All right!
Yeah, all right. Yeah, come on!
Oh, that is wicked.
That actually is wicked.
That is wicked.
I went on this ride called The Revenge of the Mummy. I just love scary rides, they're just brilliant. And then we went on this ride called Jurassic Park, and then at the end there was like a 80 foot drop. It felt like it was massive. So you're Sam, stand back.
That's really good. Alright, yeah.
He's amazing, isn't he?
Of course he is. He's like, you know, super.
It was completely different to flying as a superhero. It was like, it was just unbelievable. You had the wind blowing in your hair. Well, not exactly, through your helmet, but it was awesome.
Dude, that was awesome! Wow!
Yeah, all in the day's work for superhero.
Yeah, come on. Having a good time?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah.
You?
Yeah.
I mean, I expected it to be good, but this is just amazing what it's been like so far.
Oh, I love New York.
It's Hollywood.
Yeah.
Oh, what's this?
Shall we find out?
Coming up, H2O Man faces one last mission. We reveal the bits you didn't see. And H2O Man finally meets Stan Lee.
Now tell me, are you ready to be immortalized as the next great superhero?
Now, as a superhero, there are a few rules you should always follow. but it took our wannabe heroes a while to grasp them. Rule number one. A superhero should never reveal their secret identity.
What's your real name, Nomads?
Jacob.
What's your real name?
April.
What's your real name?
Beth.
You said your name.
I said Beth.
You're real.
Oh!
James.
Charlie.
And that includes any information that could lead to their secret identity.
Are you from London?
No, from Huddersfield.
Where are you from originally?
I was from Newcastle.
Did I detect a Bristol accent there?
Yeah.
Yeah, for a South East Londoner, you know, to go to Hollywood, yeah, is a big thing.
Rule number two. A superhero should be brave and courageous, particularly when facing the unknown.
Oh, whoa, I know what that is. Oh, God, I know what that is.
Rule three, a true superhero is honest at all times. Rule number four, a superhero does not seek fame and fortune.
If you aren't standing up, I'm giving us your superhero pose, please.
Oh,
you're brilliant.
Now, you're clearly a true superhero. Are you looking forward to fame and fortune now that everyone knows who you are?
Yeah.
Are you?
Most definitely.
Superheroes, thank you so much for all you've done for me.
And as for the fortune part...
As a reward for what you've done, I want to give you £1 each.
Oh, that's really nice.
Thank you so much. I'm so grateful.
Thank you very much.
No?
Keep it.
Okay. Thank you. Well, thank you very much.
Come on, take it with me.
Okay, see you later. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
I've still got my £1. Oh, you...
I knew that was gonna happen.
And finally, rule number five, a true superhero always helps those in need.
Excuse me, can you give me the restroom, please? I have to go to the moon. Can you please tell me what you say? I have to go to the moon, me, my friend. I'm not from this country. I'm very lost. Please, come on, you can help me. Excuse me, can you help me? I need a direction, please. Excuse me, I've really have to make my way to the moon. Can you please help me?
She dropped us shopping.
If somebody was in trouble, you would just want to get there as fast as possible. So that's how I ran so fast.
So those are the top five rules to becoming a superhero. Simple, really.
Weird, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit creepy.
Yeah. I've got a good feeling about this.
What's that?
It's a shark!
I do not like this place.
We definitely need to get out of here.
Get out! Can I get out? Oh, it's no use. We're never going to get out. We need help. H2O Man! H2O Man!
H2O Man is here!
H2O, over here!
Over here! I knew he'd come!
What is this place? It's creepy. What happened?
Guys, it's a film set with a light and a camera.
Ah!
Oh, come on, let's get out of it.
Now, over the past weeks, we've had one mission: to find a brand new superhero.
Listen up. The purpose of this show is to find out which of you has all the essential qualities of a superhero. And right now, the world needs you more than ever.
And in the battle to become the world's next great superhero, we were watching their every move to see who possessed the qualities of a true superhero. One of the qualities we were looking for the superheroes to demonstrate was courage.
Superheroes, what are you doing over there? You're meant to be over here.
The only way of getting out is across this plank.
He's gonna die.
And with the plank suspended 18 metres high and just over 30 centimetres wide, this was the superhero's first real test of bravery.
What's that doing it?
And not everyone was looking forward to it.
Take your time.
He was frightened.
Why did I have to do this?
Well done, well done. Nice one, Megamite Man. You alright?
I'm scared of my wits.
Along with his fellow superheroes, Megamite Man bravely crossed the plank, but things weren't about to get any easier.
Superheroes, listen up. The notorious supervillain Dr. Dark has raided this pet shop.
Whoa. The snakes are coming out!
The snakes are everywhere!
This mission proved easier for some...
I'm coming!
...than it did for others.
Well, I'm really scared because I'm absolutely petrified of snakes. Butterflies in my stomach, and all I was thinking is that I can't do this.
And Pink Puffle Girl wasn't the only one who struggled when it came to facing scary animals.
Okay, once you're inside, you need to choose what animal you're going to save and put it in a carry case and then get out as quickly as possible.
Most of the superheroes successfully rescued some of the animals, but Sam struggled. We were also looking for the superheroes to demonstrate teamwork.
If you can crack my riddles, you'll have the code to release your precious presenters. The first number you need can be found at the bottom of a face that has hands but no eyes.
A clock!
A clock!
A clock!
A clock!
A clock!
A clock!
One!
Six!
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 Solving the riddles and saving us wasn't the only time the superheroes worked well as a team. They retrieved toxic waste from the Thames.
God,
you okay?
Quiet.
I've got this, I'm coming over there, and Pink Puffle Girl will too.
Me and SGW did really well. I felt like a proper superhero.
And they stopped Dr. Dark from taking over the airwaves.
Your mission today is to work within your team and retrieve the rods that have been taken from the satellite dish.
The final superhero quality we were looking for was compassion. Towards the public...
Just some help with that?
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, do you need any help there, madam?
Oh, thank you ever so much.
I have to go to the moon.
Can we see him?
That one?
Yes, not that one.
Grazie! Ciao! Thank you!
And of course, their fellow superheroes.
You can do it, you can!
Somebody, it's really hard, isn't it?
Nobody said it was going to be easy.
But it wasn't easy for us either. Deciding which superhero should be powered down got harder each week.
As you know, this is the moment when we will ask one superhero to power down, transform back into their secret identity and leave the lair for good.
Please, could you tell us why you think you should remain in the lair?
I will change and I'm really sorry for what I did.
I do act like a dolphin and went a bit crazy in the head.
All I've wanted is to be a superhero.
I know a lot of people say this, but it's a dream for me.
I'm doing it for all the girls who have been powered down.
I just hope you make the right decision and keep me in the lair.
But sadly, 10 of the superheroes have to power down. Coming up...
It's now time for you and Stan to have a bit of one-on-one time.
How about that?
Oh, my word.
See the superheroes as you've never seen them before.
Hello, long loops.
And H2O Man gets one last surprise.
Ready for this?
Yep.
There we go! H2O Man, the time is almost upon us. You're about to meet superhero godfather, Mr. Stan Lee, and receive your very own comic book. How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm so excited, but a little bit nervous.
Well, the only advice we can give you is just be yourself, mate.
Definitely. Yep. Remember, you are the world's next great superhero. Give us your superhero pause.
Yeah!
OK, we've taken you as far as we can on this journey. It's now time for you and Stan to have a bit of one-on-one time. Go get him, kid.
Wow. I wish I had that power.
Yeah. Coffee?
Nah, I'll have a juice.
All right.
I want to be a superhero.
From the first auditions, H2O Man was a great potential superhero.
I've got a different attitude to superheroes. I don't just think it is beating up someone and then you being the good guy. I think you've got to put a message across. I'm a superhero with a message.
He showed determination and enthusiasm in the missions.
No.
Six, seven, oh, four.
Yes!
And also demonstrated bravery and courage.
Go, go, go!
Oi, what's going on?
Just stay calm. Are you okay? Are you hurt anywhere?
No, you saved me!
He proved popular in the lair.
I think H2O Man did, like, really well. Not
a squat! One, two, three, four, and squat! One, two, three, and squat!
Where even good superheroes make mistakes.
H2O Man, please step forward.
Going on your track record, we're surprised to see you here, but turning your paper over and reading the answers was a blatant rule break.
I think that was just one little silly mistake which shouldn't have really happened. I should have thought before I acted.
But, like a true superhero, H2O Man took our advice on board and learned from his mistakes.
And became our next great superhero.
H2O Man.
Who gets to meet Stan Lee? Not a lot of people. And Stan Lee's awesome. And it means so much to me to win.
The time has finally come for H2O Man to meet his superhero godfather, Stan Lee.
Well, it's about time. You must be H2O Man. I've been expecting you. Well, hey, it's a pleasure to meet you at last.
I'm honored to meet you too, Mr. Lee.
Well, thank you. Well, welcome to the superhero family, but remember, with great power comes great responsibility. Now, I trust you've been using your powers responsibly.
Yes, I've been doing what I can with what I've got, all for good causes, of course, and it's just amazing to be a superhero.
That's good to hear. Now, I've been observing you for quite a while, and I've been putting all my energies into creating the best comic book for you, H2O Man. So, what are you expecting from this comic book?
Well, I don't really know what to expect, but I'm just so happy that someone like you can make a comic for me.
Well, I've spent a while thinking about what H2O Man should do, and mainly, who his arch nemesis should be. I think I've created a great character for you to battle against. I think you're gonna like this. Now tell me, are you ready to be immortalized as the next great superhero?
Yep, I can't wait. The time has actually finally come.
Okay then, here goes. Oh, this is gonna be a big moment.
Oh my word. That is awesome.
And you're the hero. It all started on an ordinary day in London when a strange man walked into a bank. Everybody stand back if you value your lives. I warned you. Give me all the money in the bank or I'll make the circle of flame smaller and smaller.
No, no, we'll give you whatever you want.
Wow, another big bank robbery.
Uh-oh, sounds like trouble. What happened, guys?
It's the fire fiend. He struck again. That's his fifth robbery in a week.
They'll never be able to stop a fire fiend.
Never say never.
Where's Carl running off to?
Maybe the talk about the fire fiend frightened him.
It's time for H2O Man to go into action. The next time the fire fiend strikes, I'll be ready for him.
Here's a bank just waiting for me to rob. Ha! We thought you'd strike here. You're under arrest. You can't arrest me.
Why not?
Because nothing can beat my firepower.
There he is.
Who said that?
The name's H2O. And you, mister, are history.
Water. The one thing that can destroy me.
Nothing can defeat the power of H2O.
Beaten by a boy? This is embarrassing. Where did H2O go?
I wonder who H2O really is.
Well, we'll probably never know.
Are you happy with your comic book alter ego?
It's me. I'm actually a superhero. Oh, it's awesome.
Yeah, I think it's pretty good, too.
Looks action-packed from the start.
Right. And you look pretty good there, huh?
Yep, I look just like me.
Well, it's a pleasure to me to see that you're every bit the superhero that I thought you were and that I hoped you would be.
Thank you so much, Stan.
It was really a pleasure, H2O.
Oh, my God, it's unbelievable. I've just met Stan Lee. He's such a cool person. I just got my comic book, and I feel like a real superhero. The comic book, it's just amazing. It's unbelievable. I didn't expect it to be this good. Colours are just amazing. It's got some bits that are just so like me, like on the trampoline. You're like, that's something I do in everyday life, playing my guitar. And then when I'm getting changed, it's got a picture of the trophies that I've won and a guitar. It's just awesome.
It was funny, after I met H2O Man, I was thinking if I were doing a comic book about a young, teenage superhero, I'd probably have him look just like H2O Man. It was amazing how he just was perfect. When you think of somebody wearing a cape and a superhero costume, it's okay in a comic book, but you sort of figure in real life he'd look a little silly. The thing that amazed me, he didn't look silly. I mean, that costume actually looked good on him. He looked as though that's what he should wear. I forgot that he's a kid wearing a costume, but everything just seemed so natural.
I wonder how H2O Man's getting on with Stan.
Well, I'm sure they're getting on really well. Hey, I can't wait to see what he thinks of that comic book.
I know. Comic book, it's amazing. Yeah. Superheroes are amazing.
Hey, I'll tell you what, you'll never see them making a fool of themselves, yeah.
I wouldn't be so sure. The superheroes may have looked the part, but they weren't super serious all the time.
Yes!
How cool!
And neither were we.
Action. Okay, dude, I reckon these should do the trick. Sam! Okay, dude, this should do the trick. Okay, dude, I reckon these should do the trick.
Of course, there were a few mishaps along the way.
To his old tricks, and this time it's
me. See, eating your 5 a day can be fun.
When words fail, you can always rely on a silly face.
Hello, long looks.
Please don't go.
I come from Sweden.
And don't like Sam.
Hey, television.
Come on, it's not working.
Roger, 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 camera, camera. Roger, 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 camera, camera.
And even superheroes get a little tongue-tied at times.
I think Hitch was.
I think. Goodness.
I think H2O's man best qualities is great.
I think
I think H2O's best qualities is looks. If I was a girl, I would date him.
That really hurts.
The best you smelt it, felt it.
And there's one person we mustn't forget, Dr. Dark.
Those super zeros are going to pay for this! What a loser.
You said it, Dr. Dark.
I'm really nervous. Really want to know how we got on with Stan.
I know. Oh! Here he is, you alright?
Hey, how was it then? How was Stan?
It was really fun, actually. He's such a nice guy, Stan is. Honestly.
He's wicked, isn't he?
Yes. Yeah.
And more importantly, how does it feel to be a real comic book character?
Oh, it's unbelievable. It's really hard to describe. Yeah.
Come on then, let's have a look. I'm dying to see it.
Let's have a look. Wow.
I know.
Look at that.
Wicked.
That's awesome. Look at that.
So sad.
And so how's it feel being up there with the greats then? Incredible Hulk, Spider-Man?
Oh, now I'm actually there. It's just unbelievable. I thought about it and now I'm actually there. I can't describe how good it is.
Now, we not only think of you as a brilliant superhero in the comic book, we think you're a brilliant superhero in real life as well, mate.
Yeah, and we have got one more treat for you. Now, it's not as good as, you know, being immortalised in a comic book by Stan Lee, but it's the next best thing.
Yeah, and a superhero wouldn't be a superhero without one of these.
Here we go. You ready for this?
Yeah.
No. Nervous.
There we go!
What? That's awesome!
How cool is that? Shall we get it out? Here you go,
look
mate.
At that, dude.
That is yours.
That's awesome. Cheers, guys.
That's a pleasure, mate.
How good's that, man?
I love that. That's wicked.
That is actually modelled on you. The face, the costume, everything.
That's awesome.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
Look, you got the hair right.
Nice.
Really
good.
Cheers.
Well, H2O Man, it's been an absolute pleasure, and you do make an incredible superhero.
But the journey has now come to an end. It's now time for you to branch out as a superhero on your own. The world needs you.
Oh, don't worry, guys. The world's going to be fine in my hands. But right now, I've got to go.
Oh, why?
Someone in trouble?
Is there a terrible crime happening right now?
With Dr. Dark and his evil piggy henchmen about to rear their ugly heads?
No. My mum's calling me. I've got to go for tea.
Ow. Okay. Excelsior.
Excelsior.
What a hero.
Coming to Hollywood, it's just been amazing. It's been brilliant, really. I mean, I went to Universal, hanged out with Sam and Mark, and of course, I met Stan Lee. You don't really get to meet Stan Lee every day, and it's just awesome that I actually got to meet Stan Lee. He's such a good role model for all superheroes, and he made all the best superheroes, like the Hulk, Spider-Man, so I'm in that family now. For Stan Lee to think that I'm such a like good role model, that just means everything to me, really. What else could a superhero want?
Well, I don't know about H2O, man, but I reckon we've had a journey of epic proportions.
Yeah, from meeting Stan Lee and learning everything there is to know about superheroes.
To picking the final 13 from the hundreds of applicants that applied to take part.
And not forgetting all the missions that we put our superheroes through.
And the tough job of sending 12 of them home.
But we had a job to do, to find the world's next great superhero. And now we've done that, it's time for us to go.
Excelsior!
One small step for a superhero, one giant leap for humankind.
Superheroes, welcome to what will become the adventure of a lifetime.
Steel soldier, flying feather, deflector.
Oh!
You gotta get changed without anyone seeing you and then pass the finish line as quick as possible.
Oh!
She dropped a shopping. And I just ran laughing.
Superheroes! What are you doing over there? You're meant to be over here.
The only way of getting out is across this plank.
You're gonna die.
Superhero who will power down and return home is Ms. Dungarees. I don't think we're going to have a harder decision than that throughout the rest of the series.
Hi, who are you?
I'm H2O Man.
Oh, someone has broken into my apartment.
Do I think red? Well, it does go with gold.
I think it goes with gold really nicely, actually.
By the law, state your name.
Fern. Let's check it for Texas.
Dr. Dark. He's only one of the most notorious supervillains around.
It's like the Grim Reaper.
There's no time to waste. Your assistance is required immediately.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
We're the bravest superhero.
Yeah.
I am.
Most definitely.
I'll vote for every single question.
Dolphin Girl.
Megamite Man.
Everybody's proud of them, the fact that they did their best.
Go, go, go!
hope you're all feeling super and heroic this morning.
I am the infamous Doctor.
Superheroes, do you think you can do it?
Yes! Please, Doctor Doc!
My name is Tiki Tiki. I'm from Hawaii. Did you recognize me? Ah.
My name is Makoto. Nothing about this pink platform.
Get your hands off me.
You better hurry up. I'm getting bored of this.
Sorry.
Flying feather. Nine lives.
We're all just sitting around. It's quite sad at the moment. People are crying. It's really emotional. It's sad.
He does look a little bit like you.
In your face.
We might be getting a prize for this.
Sanf.
Yes! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Are you guys okay?
Deflector?
What's her name?
Deflector.
Each time somebody gets powered down, it does, the layer does change.
Okay, I know what it is, Oh,
guys, you need to hurry up. It looks like the henchman's coming back. They're getting closer, guys. Come on.
Are you okay, H2O? Do you want me to come back?
Princess Paul. Steel Soldier.
Wait, just concentrate. I'm not doing anything to shoot this wall,
isn't it? You keep looking over there. Just calm down.
You've all come so far on this epic journey. The superhero that will power down and return home is... Pink Puffle Girl.
Ah! Give me the final. Being in the final three is just... wow.
The world needs a new superhero. And I can now reveal that that hero is H2O Man.
Hotter with the CBBC superstars.
What?
Surprise!
Let's get this party started.
Run! Have a superstar summer. All this week with CBBC.